Hi, Arjan Kuipers here. The hidden dangers of using an AFO, ankle foot orthosis or ankle brace. What do I mean with this? Well, after a stroke, many of you are dealing with a so-called foot drop. The foot drops, the foot turns in, you're not able to lift your foot before heel strike, because the muscles on the front get weaker and the muscles on the back get relatively stronger. And this has to do with the changed position of the muscles in humans that makes it possible that we are upright. So the front muscles in our leg extend, help to work against gravity, but anti-gravity muscles, like the ones in the back above the sixth thoracic vertebra that keep us upright, they get weaker after a stroke, and we see that the gravity assisting muscles that do this, flex and bicep use, pectoral use, they get stronger, like the muscles on the backside of the legs, which are really the front muscles in animals, but they have turned to the back in humans. They also get stronger, and then we see that the foot turns in and that we have to start swinging our leg around using the back muscles to sling the leg forward to get forward propulsion, but at the same time we lose the forward swing because the quadriceps and the anterior tibialis, which I talk about in a separate The Anatomy of Foot Drop mini masterclass, they get lost, the foot drops, you cannot clear the ground. So that is the situation after a stroke for many of you, especially after a middle cerebral artery stroke. A brace is a safety feature. So it makes sure that you get up and going again, which is very important for your health. It makes sure that there's not more accidents. That's the last thing you want after a stroke, is that you get injured because you fall, because you trip over and you don't have the control over your leg. The whole leg is usually weak. So we get a brace around the ankle and a brace that the ankle foot orthosis lift the foot. So when you propulse forward, even if it's with a compensatory movement, you can clear the ground. So it's safe. And because it's safe, many of you use the brace for too long period. Initially it's very important, but you should start immediately with practice to lose the brace in the end. And even if it's safe and it will prevent you from stumbling and having to put too much energy in if you start to walk, which is difficult in itself when you're dealing with paresis and spasticity, but you should really aim at losing this brace. Why is this? Because when you do not use your foot actively or your ankle activity, then you lose function in the end. So using a brace is safe in the beginning and it can prevent injury, and you have to be very careful with how you go about it. And Linda, one of the co-founders of Brain Rehab, was very drastic with this. She decided, going on a holiday, to lose the brace, so she could actually, she was forced to put more effort in lifting her foot, which actually helped her within 3 weeks to get rid of her brace completely. Basically, she decided one day not to use it anymore, and from there on she forced herself to get more activity in lifting her foot, which she succeeded in. That is maybe not the best way to do it, but it certainly makes sure that your body has to do anything possible, and I'm going to talk about that in the next item, to start lifting the foot actively by yourself. If you don't do that, you lose function, you lose the neuronal networks that are still there, and usually there are neuronal networks, there are areas of your brain that can take over this function, but it will take a lot of purposeful practice. So a lot of repetition, and I'm not talking about 10 times, I'm talking about 100 times, 100 of times per day, lot of small series of walking exercises. You can do that in the beginning with the help of a cane or a tripod. But after it, you should start to do that on your own, which is a very difficult task because it takes a lot of time and repetition to train function back while walking. So, and this, you can get rid of the brace within a couple of months, maybe a couple of weeks even, usually 1 to 3 months. But after it, the real training, the purposeful training starts because you're still making compensatory movements, which is for a different block or training. So when you get rid of the brace, that's at least should be at the forefront of your mind from the start, even if it's very uncomfortable. All uncomfortable things are uncomfortable at the start. When you make it a habit, a daily practice, which we talk about in another block and masterclass, you can actually do this, and it will not take you automatically start doing this, not using the brace. And even if you think, now I can never get rid of my brace because it's so comfortable, it prevents me from falling, think again. Because if you don't use your ankle, you will lose function. You will not only lose the representation in your brain, in the somatosensory cortex, in the parietal lobe, but you also will use the networks that are assisting you in lifting your foot. Doesn't matter if you had your stroke 10 years ago, you can still work on losing your brace if you're still using it. Best to start with it right from the start. The brace is there for safety in the start, fine, but you should aim at losing it as quickly as possible. That brings me to the third item, is that you have to use plasticity that we were talking about, the neuroplasticity, the capacity of your brain to change, to really start getting function back. And you can do that actively and passively. Maybe you do not have any control, then you can assist the movement with your other foot, with your hand. You can do that upwards, sidewards, so you compensate for the inward rotation of your leg. You can put your leg on a little support and start lifting the leg passively by putting your weight on. Lean a little bit so you lose the inner rotation of the foot outwards. And you can also use a sling made from, for example, elastic band or a small towel or a tea towel, which is a little bit thinner, or a sheet that you can hold in your good hand, and you can start lifting the leg in that way. At the same time, you think through what you are doing. When you're looking at a movie or where people are running or walking, you are thinking that you are doing it. In other blog and video, we are talking about mirror exercises, where you actually show the exercises on the good side and you actually look at the mirror that is covering the affected side, and your brain literally is fooled in thinking that the movement is back. So you're literally training your brain, actively engaging your brain, through neuroplasticity, training the networks that are still there, and that the areas that are still function, that can take over function, is the only way to actively start moving your ankle up again. And in the anatomy mini masterclass, I explain how the ankle works, why certain muscles get weak, why you should activate those muscles to get rid of the foot drop. So we talked a little bit already about passive exercise, but active exercise that are really assisting this process is really not only thinking about what you're going to do, that you're lifting your foot, and that you, instead of your foot is usually inward rotated, because the muscles that lift your foot, they also rotate your foot and keep your foot a little bit outwards, together with the peroneus, longus, brevis, tertius muscles. And that is what you are thinking through. So you're actually making the repetition of thinking through the motion, which is already engaging your brain, engaging the networks that are still present, then you're trying to lift it. And doesn't matter if you can not hardly lift it, any movement is okay. So you start with repeating upward motion of your foot, even if it's the tiniest of movement. It starts with tiny movements. And doing that over and over again, literally you can start with 10, 20 repetitions per time, 6 times a day, maybe even more today, but in the end you should do hundreds of repetitions every day. Neuroplasticity is created by purposeful practice. So purposeful meaning the best possible movement you can bring into it and in the right, correct direction, not in all kinds of ways, so you start compensating, you're not building your brain properly, it should be purposeful, there should be a lot of repetition, you can even combine the lifting movements, exercises, if you can do them actively, by using full body strategies that we talk about in other videos. You can use electrical muscle stimulation. There's a lot of devices on the market where you put 2 stickers on the anterior tibialis muscle. Again, look at the anatomy of a foot drop mini masterclass. And you can start stimulating the muscle at the same time that you're practicing. And that makes it literally possible that you can get rid of a foot drop and you can start building down, which should be done gradually, of using the brace. Because the front of your leg becomes stronger, you start to be able to lift your foot, even if it will take years to perfect this practice through walking exercises, which we describe in the How to Start Walking Again, where we show literally how you can use exercises to get better at walking again, losing the typical swing that we see after a stroke that overcomes spasticity and weakness paresis in the leg. Very important, you have to do all of this gradual, so you don't injure yourself. You should be wise about it. When you lose your brace, do it a little bit in the beginning, but do it as quickly as possible and start actively and passively exercising the affected foot. Very important. And that brings me to the last item. The best practice for doing this is active movements with or without electrical muscle stimulation. But there are a lot of strategies which we describe in brain.rehab, where we use the other side. We use opposite movements, cross-court movements with the arms. So when you're walking, you swing one arm forward, the opposite leg goes forward. We use these type of movements to assist lifting the foot. So if we normally swing the leg forward on the left side, we actually extend the arm and the fingers on the other side. So you can use movements of your good arm to assist lifting the foot. So if you do that at the same time, so using the hand and the foot at the same time, you actually assist getting back this movement. So you use cord mechanisms, you use supraspinal, so top-down mechanisms to support this movement. And this is besides that we have to look at, is the proper neurological development there? We can use bottom-up mechanisms that we described in the bottom-up approach, where we use brainstem mechanisms on top of the spinal cord mechanisms with the cross-crawl exercise that I just showed. Then we look at the vestibular integration and the core and postural stability that is needed to get a stable leg or arm movement, or even talking or cognition is dependent on proper core stability. Full body strategies are the best, and that combined with local active movement activities, that is the best strategy for getting rid of a foot drop. I hope this has been inspirational and I clarified some things for you. I would suggest that you look also at the anatomy of a foot drop video for more and in further depth clarification of what I just explained to you. See you in the next blog.